Hello, and welcome back, if you left, that is, or if you just came here. This is a game in Star Series, Star Ladder, and we are here with DD, or to be announced, as they don't know their team name yet, or their sponsor name, versus SGC Storm Games Clan, formerly known as Epidemic. And it's going to be a one game, so... Yeah, we're just waiting for everybody to load in so we can start it off and get the show on the road. And I actually don't have a co-caster for this, in case you didn't notice yet what the silence was. So, yeah. That's something you're just going to have to deal with, I guess. Radiant team and we have the picks and bans. Wow, they're going fast. So we have a Broodmother ban out. We have a Lone Druid. We have a Lycan ban. Furion. Invoker still in. Gen still in. Pandaren is still in. So one of the two that I just said Radiant is definitely going to go ban. Through. Is it going to be Invoker? Is it going to be Gen? We, of course, also still have Leshrac, Tidehunter, Windrunner, and stuff like that, so don't worry about those. They'll probably be in. And there we have the Darkseer being picked up as the first pickup, as Invoker got banned out for the last ban. And Darkseer being there might mean that we also mean see an Enigma on DD, unless SGC is going to pick it up instead. Let's see. Oh yeah, I have to change the name of my Twitch. So sorry, I will do that right now while we wait so that people aren't confused about what we're watching, because we are watching Star Series with SGC versus DD. Star Series update. Fixed. Just in case you were wondering. So yeah, first pick for SGC, taking their time, taking into their reserve time for it even. They have got quite a bit of options, Venomance. And they're going to go actually for Venomancer, or something that I was not expecting, and Leshrac also to have Tulix, to give Tulix something to play, which will leave the Chen still in and to be picked up for DD. And Queen of Pain is their third pickup, and then Chandra's being picked up straight afterwards. So that's going to be at least the first three picks for both teams before we go on to the next ban phase. And Chandra's being a good counter to Chen, making sure they still have the chance to pick that up. And well, Leshrac is a good player, good hero to have. I mean, late game, early game, he's always have a stun, always has his utility, always can push down towers or anything very fast. And yeah, Venomancer there too as their support. No support yet, or no hardcore support yet for DD. Might see that being still picked up. We have a Earthshaker ban and a Morphling ban, and a Sand King ban too. So that leads me to believe that they might pick up the Sand, the Tidehunter or something as their first pickup, or to just deny the team fight abilities to SGC. I mean, Tidehunter is basically the only, well, and Enigma. Okay, they could still go for Enigma and have Darkseer Enigma combination going on. Which is, of course, very powerful. But let's see if SGC is going to let that happen. There, at least there's a Morphling ban out, making sure that DD is not going to get that hard carry, but there's still, of course, plenty of hard carries left. Dire team pick. And Mirana is going to be the last ban out for SGC, denying that for DD. Wow, these shortcut names. Confusing, isn't it? Let's see what the first pickup is going to be after this benefit. It's going to actually be a Shadow Demon for their support. Radiant team. And Shadow Demon, yeah, it's a good support. I mean, I got only good words for the Shadow Demon. He can help in team fights, but just making someone, disappear with a disruption, making sure the fight is 4 versus 5. He can save a teammate from going down, delaying a kill, or maybe saving a kill, maybe especially, for example, if they have the Queen of Pain, who would be able to blink out straight after the disruption happened if she wasn't able to blink out before. So a good save ability there. And of course, at early game, so powerful for ganking. You can just disrupt someone, wait for everybody to get in position. Maybe the Chen come out of the forest, or for Darkseer to come surge his way over there, or Queen of Pain to blink in, and take a kill. And of course, Soulcatcher, super powerful. Extra spell damage taken, so painful. So, as you see, taking their time, taking into more bonus time. Let's see what they need. Well, I still think an Enigma or a Tidehunter wouldn't be bad, but let's see if that fits into their line. I mean, they will have Enchantress in the forest. They have Lashrek, which can basically do anything. He can support, even though Vendomancer is probably going to be their support. He can go solo mid. He can go side solo,
And
even though that's not
damage.
really. Nah, okay. We're probably going to see a dual lane.
Guardian pick.
Or, yeah, dual lane with. Oh, this is going to be
Radiant
weird.
team pick.
Dual lane with a Venomancer and the Anti-Mage, mid lane for Lashrek, and still the mid solo lane left over for picks as a Dragonite pick gets picked up without any hesitation from Miguel as the last pick for DD. Or to be announced. I kind of don't know what to call them right now. You can understand my confusion. The teams that are playing right now are DD versus SGC, Storm Games Clan, and DD or XQuantic to be announced, as they don't have their no sponsors yet. They're gonna pick up a Klinks. Whoa, whoa. So let's see if Klinks gonna be middle or side solo, or maybe anti-mage solo. We have a lot of options to go for at least. I will just check out switch the overlays so that you can. You can see more than just the overlay for the captain's mode thingies. I'm waiting for everybody to pick their heroes. So no
Dire
Tidehunter,
Titans
even though I
reign.
was really thinking that he would be picked up. So the only real extra teamfight
Five
hero is a
seconds
Darkseer.
remaining.
Even though, of course, I mean, Chen is teamfight with his heal. Lashrek is teamfight. Venomance teamfight, but not the same kind, I believe. So let's just go over what everybody's playing here. We see Angel playing the Dragonite. We see Miguel on the Darkseer. Playmate is playing the Queen of Pain. Ryze on the Shadow Demon. And last but not least is Mania on the Chen. Who's gonna go out into the forest. And we probably have a solo lane for the Darkseer. Or maybe he's even gonna go jungle with the Queen of Pain solo lane and Shadow Demon and a Dragonite on the. Well, of course, no Queen of Pain in the middle. Darkseer on the side solo lane and a dual lane for Angel and Ryze. Okay, in the meantime, on the and as you see, we have Tulex playing his Lashrak, Ofak is playing the Venomancer, Kranius is playing the Klinks, Warlock is playing the Anti-Mage, and the last one that has not been picked yet is Lasek, who is playing the. Crap. What's gonna be? What's the other one? So, well, Enchantress, of course. Yeah, it's gonna be Enchantress. We have a couple of shoutouts coming out, so it's cool. Having fun. Shout out to KGB, Ice Frog. Definitely shout out to Ice Frog. Can say that. And Klinks resumed the game, so Kranius is ready for this. Let's see who's going where, as they do have quite a bit of options here, apart from Enchantress going into the jungle.
Prepare for
Enchantress
battle.
also picking up a donkey. And, wow. Nine tangos on the Anti-Mage. He actually got three from someone else. And we're gonna see a trial lane coming out from these teams, or nope. Klinks in the middle lane. Anti-Mage is probably. Wow. What's everybody gonna do? Well, Anti-Mage is looking to go towards the bot lane, but a solo bot lane for the Anti-Mage doesn't seem all that likely, even though he will be up versus the Darkseer, leaving him to maybe get a little bit extra farm, but Darkseer will have his Iron Shell. That will be very annoying for an Anti-Mage, so I'm still expecting someone to come back. Especially if Enchantress is also going towards the top lane, because she would. Yeah. This can't be their laning.
30 seconds
Or
to
that would be
battle.
really, really unorthodox, and will definitely throw DD off. So let's see who's playing who, where for DD. And Miguel on the bottom lane. You just saw the Darkseer there, with the Chen standing here, seemingly going towards the enemy forest on the Radiant side, with Angel in the middle. On his Dragonite, will be up first the Klinks. Will get harassed a bit, but.
The
I think
battle
he should be fine.
begins.
He's saving his gold to get a fast bottle up. And Playmate on the top lane with Shadow Demon, maybe switching towards the middle lane to help out the Dragonite. You will actually pick up the invisibility rune, which Enchantress will spot. Hello. She's gonna warden back off. Now they see each other. Okay, so we do have a solo lane Entimage right now. Surprising. But then again. Okay, well, we'll see how this works out. This is a Dragonite versus the Klings. Well, I think we'll be in favor of Drainage. But we will see. As soon as he gets a Sol Ring up for Dragonite, that will be a different story, as he will be able to get more farm that way. The top lane is probably the lane where the most action is going to happen. A Shadow Demon is there with an Invisibility Rune. Seeing Enchantress taking out there, but there's a Gale on the Queen of Pain. Did manage to blink away. Don't think they want to dive this. Nope. Go back. There we go. Not overextending. Hello, Enchantress. Might get a last hit here as a Centaur takes off the... takes up the tower hit. Ursa Warrior is there, Chen coming out of the forest. Enchantress is gonna be a fierce blood going towards the Queen of Pain. But Queen of Pain dropping there too, to the Enchantress, to his centaur, and at least. As Chen sends his creep back to the base, or someone back to the base. Ryze is gonna take a fall here to Two Legs, but Two Legs is gonna drop here too. As Slaymate TPs in and claims, well, helps out on Chen getting a kill on the Lushrak. So 2 for 2 with the fierce blood going towards Playmate on the Queen of Pain, and that well, that definitely started out the game. Ooh, Venomantis still throwing off, and Gale might be in some trouble here as the Shrank teleports in, helping out. Might get a stun off on Les Chen. There we go, stun going off. Edict going off too, slow going off too. He won't be able to survive this. As Les Shrank takes the last hit, Queen of Pain should be backing off now. Does have a blink, so should be fine. Doesn't seem like SGC wants to follow this up either. No. So that was some quick kills, with in the end actually an extra kill for SGC. Even though of course Queen of Pain took the first blood. Let's see who actually got those kills. We have 2 for Lushrak, so great start for him. And he is actually the one that's farming here on this top lane. So an extra good start for him then. And Queen of Pain actually taking kill, but also dying one, so yeah. But he got the first blood. First blood bunny. Forcing out fortification with the level 2 edict. A word from the Dai here to make sure that they know where everybody is. And this sentry ward is not spawning out that ward. That's a bit aggressive. I wonder what they're gonna go for this. Ah, hello. Also a normal ward. I don't know what this ward was about. It was a bit weird. Maybe he was expecting the ward to be in a closer range, but yeah, doesn't spot that out, so oh well. In the meantime, let's see how bottom lane is doing, because I'm quite curious how this Entimage is gonna be going for the solo lane. Mikael, who's out of mana, so no Iron Shell for him yet, as Entimage is 10 for 1 last hit, and Darkseer being 12 for 1. So far quite even, and yeah, he's not gonna have a mana for a while if Entimage keeps blinking and harassing him out of mana. So that will be a good job for him, as the jungle gets farmed up by Enchantress. They might want to go for this again, but they are going to find the Queen of Pain. The Centaur tanking up again, taking the tower up again, and Queen of Pain getting killed when she blinked out away from the forest. Gotta do a shout. Slow is going to come in here soon too, as the right-click drops. Blink is off cooldown again, though she is fine. Even Gale's still ticking, yeah, she will be fine. She has a Tangos too, so no kill again, but nice harassment for her to get out of the lane from SGC. And ooh, we might have a gank here incoming, as Ryze is moving towards the bottom lane, full health, full mana, might be taking all this Entimage if they're gonna get a good disruption in. As the lane is pushed out towards the tower, which you don't see that often with the Darkseer there, as he would be keeping his Iron Shell, but with no mana he's not able to do that, so the lane doesn't get pushed out as much as it normally would. Hello, Chen. They notice that we have to shut down this Entimage faster, he will farm too much. And they're gonna go that as the disruption comes out, giving Chen some time to join in this. Blink is not there, as there's no mana on the Entimage. With the illusions there too, Shadow Demon taking the last hit with the Shadow Poison, and that's a kill that they well, that's definitely worth for everybody to come off their lane and take that kill. And that's gonna be the pain with the illusions from the Shadow Demon, as the illusions that the disruption creates will also suck away mana from their target, so Entimage not having mana to blink away there. Really annoying for him. So Queen of Pain trying to get a kill, and then Chantress, Queen of Pain being level 4, and Chantress level 2, so it does have the advantage, but there the Venomancer just placing a ward saying, hey, don't mess with my Enchantress. And she doesn't. That's cool. Doesn't even get the kill on the Alpha Wolf either, doesn't want to chase. Rather continuing towards the mid lane where the fight between Angel and Kranis is still going for the last hit. 30 for 6 for Klinks and 26 for 3 on the 27 for 3 on the Dragonite. So still very even, if only 3 last is different. They haven't been able to kill each other yet. Oh. Dire's top tower is under attack. Look at this tower going down. There's still no fortification up. Not even 6 minutes in, and tier 2 tower is already being pressured as well, Kranis eats something in the jungle to get his attack power up. In the meantime, there's a dive up for the Anti-Mage, with Chen coming out of the forest, Shadow Demon being there, but there is a lot of mana on the Anti-Mage, so we'll be able to blink away. No worries there. Tower is gonna drop though. Venomancer taking the last hit. Enchantress being there for the whole time too, not being able to go out into the jungle all that much, rather taking, sharing the experience here, so it's still level 2. Well, even Venomancer is level 4, disruption on the Anti-Mage, we'll be able to blink away though, it's gonna be fine, and Shadow Poison still will, won't do anything anymore, he'll be fine. Tower is still alive though, so they're fighting in between towers, but the Creep Wave will push in, and
bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah. We'll be taken down right now as Chen is there too. Chen being level 4. Let's take a quick look at the experience graph before this tower drops. Radiant's so in favor of SGC, not surprising with Radiant's them taking down 2 towers and fallen. Also having 3 kills, so only 1 kill difference. But yeah. That was not a surprising. Well, there's the tower. See? Going back to 1.5k, which is actually the exact amount of a tower if you count the right click with that last hit. Let's see if Kranis can take, or can at least do some extra damage on the Dragonite. There is a bottle charge still up, so it's so far it's just harassing. He's not been able to, or has not left his lane. He's pretty happy farming. I got an uplifting step ready. He's going towards the Orchid, as there's no Soul Ring on the Dragonite, so he can't really spam out his Breath of Fire yet. But then again, does he really want to do that? Because that would mean pushing the lane and maybe deny himself some last hits as the lane gets pushed out too far. Disruption going off in the end, Mage Shadow Poison doesn't hit on the Venomancer. As the push continues on this bot lane, TP coming in from the Shrek. Wanna try to counter push a little bit, doesn't get stunned up on Miguel as he avoids that. And he will get sent home as he still does some damage to the Shrek. With Pop this Edict doing so much damage, Mania going down. And Kling's taking the last hit from there as he left his lane finally. And took the last hit from Chen's creeps and rises on the way out. Very smart. Klinks leaving his lane does give momentum to Angel to get this tower down. One more last right click and there we go. Dragonite gets a tower for Klinks leaving his lane. Does take a kill, takes a lot of damage, isn't still in dragon form. Might not be fine though, as they think that Shadow Demon is the real one, but it's not the real one, it's an illusion. Otherwise they could have totally taken that kill home, but just the danger of a Shadow Demon being there is enough to scare everybody off. I have a little bit of lag spikes, so I'm not dropping any frames. Doesn't seem like I do, though, so looks to be cool. Oh, Miguel, you really think you can take on Offac? You might be able to. There's no mana left. Well, nope. They're just backing off. And Anti-Mage is here, too, to help out, as the Iron Shell does some damage on Warlock, making sure that he doesn't want to push this. So, for towers, it's actually even now, with 2 towers down for both teams. And that will mean that the gold graph is almost even too. I mean, 1 kill difference. Let's take a quick look at the last hit, see where the main difference is coming from. And that will be from...
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I would say that... there's 3 people farming here. That's pretty decent. And, of course, there is last hits on the towers. I'm not sure where the change is coming from, because there's 4 people farming on TBA as well, having 40, 45 last hits. And of course there's Klinks with a lot of farm, also taking the farm from eating creeps in the jungle, so that will make a major difference. But then still. Oh well. Let's see where these two are gonna go for. What these two are gonna go for. Gonna try to catch someone out. Maybe a Ryze as he's there, might take a slow. No, Enchantra's not gonna follow up as Darkseer is there too, and they know that. So they're just gonna back off. As Miguel farms the forest, Anti-mage farms close to his tower, pretty safe. And Lashrek going
Why do
down in the
that?
top lane, where Queen of Pain took the last hit, and Mania being there to maybe push down this tier 1 tower a little bit, at least stands all those creeps there, and Angel leaving his lane and turning into a dragon to push this tower. There are supports incoming to help out, but they are on the way back because they are looking to go down. Venomancer taking a drop very fast with a long range stun. Enchantress taking a fall straight after with Queen of Pain, Sonic Wave going through to help that out. And they will definitely be able to take this tower as a heal just off the creep wave. And yeah, tower is gonna drop. And doesn't seem like SWC is, or SGC, sorry, is gonna take something in return. Mid tower is still pretty safe. Queen is not pushing this. And tier 2 tower on the bottom lane, taking some damage too from Miguel and Riot. As Antimage is forced back. And this gold craft, yeah, there we go. Down to 2k in favor of DD. With a tower dropping, that's an easy gold advantage for them. A deny on the tower, on the middle. Nice job from Queen of Pain, making sure that Kranis is not getting that gold, as he did push the tower a bit. And with Edict being there, of course, to help out. And now they're gonna defend, or try to defend, this middle bottom tower. As it's only 260 HP left, it will be left standing, but the next pushing that's gonna happen, the tower will definitely drop. Blink came from Warlock, he wants to chase this, gets disrupted. There's the Shrak incoming though, might get a good stun off. Let's see if Ryze gonna be able to do it tonight. Vacuum is there. And Ryze gets a nice chain ultimate, Ryze gets surged. Making sure he gets away, and looks like they're not gonna chase us anymore, taking the creeps and stopping the chase down, because the terror is still there, so not a long range to chase. And of course there's always the danger of people TPing in to help out, and then you might get caught out and die, and that's not good. In case you didn't know that, dying is bad. We have a Shadowblade being built up on the Dragonite to get his crits going. And of course escape if needed, but mostly for the crit, I would guess. Let's see what the rest is building. We have a Vanguard up on the Darkseer. We also got a Sol Ring, but he had it earlier on. We did see that. 600 gold. Might be going for a Pipe Pass as the next item, but didn't buy anything yet from that, so we'll see if that's actually correct. Shadow Demon is supporting in this game, so doesn't have that much, has a bit of gauntlets to get his health up, and it's gonna counter ward, or at least ward here. Oh, hello invisible clinks. As the push in happens again, there's not gonna be enough denied for this tower, or not fast enough to deny this tower, and not in deny range yet, or to defend this tower, I meant, sorry. As Queen of Pain finishes her perseverance, disruption gonna be off on the Klinks, who's gonna try to get away, but there was a sentry ward there, so people, they will have seen him. And yeah, Queen of Pain building towards her Lincoln Sphere. Wow. Hope you didn't hear that sound. Someone outside. And yeah, Dragon Knight already finishing his Shadowblade, and Anti-Mage not having that much farming, 13 minutes, has a poor man's shield, has power threats, had 1400 gold, 44 last hits, not all that much, especially not if you compare it with the Klinks, who has 77 last hits, or with the Dragonite, who has 76 last hits. So Anti-Mage not doing all that great there, and has also died once and has no kill, so is not farming all that much. But then again, it's an Anti-Mage. He will get his farm up sooner or later if the game lasts long enough, because at the moment TBA is pushing towers quite hard. In the meantime, Klinks managed to kill off the Chen on the in the Roshan pit. And that's the thing that Chen is thing that Chen has to that Klinks has to do. Roaming around trying to get kills. In the meantime, there's a fight going on this one lane as Lesek, that's his name. His Enchantress, played by Lesek, is on his way out. And doesn't get killed off. Stun from Lashrek helped out there. Well, that's confusing. And yeah, he has his Orchid completed, so that will help out. Might look to get a kill on Riot here. Nope. Isn't gonna go for that. As there is a Dragonite close by. Doesn't have any mana on the Dragonite, but there is a regen rune, so that won't be any issue. As the tier 2 tower on the bottom lane is gonna drop. A couple more last right clicks. Playmate really trying to get a last hit on that tower, but the siege creep beat him to it. Unfortunately for Playmate, but then again. There is a ward there, they do see the clinks. If they had vision, they didn't have that much vision. TP is gonna come out from Queen of Pain, who TPs towards the tier 2 tower in the middle. They might look to go for Roshan. They don't really have the level for it, but they have Chen. And Chen with creeps will be a great tank for the Roshan. So they can do that. In the meantime, Dragonite is pushing the tier 2 tower on the top lane. And just his dragon form backing off. Only Venomancer here to defend it though, so he might as well come back. And there he goes. Chen ultimate going off. Ooh, because the Darkseer was getting killed off on the bottom lane. Wow, these skills really happen at times where I'm not really watching them, aren't they? But yeah, Darkseer getting getting killed off with Enchantress taking the last hit. The Chen's ultimate didn't help anymore. Roshan is gonna come down as Chen's creeps are tanking up the Roshan. And Dragonite still in his dragon form will help out there too. And maybe pick up the Aegis also. Be even harder to kill. The Antimage has the ultimate orbs building towards his Yasha, not gonna go for Battle Fury, knows that it might not last. Well, knows that he might not have the time to farm with Battle Fury once he gets it. And there we have Queen of Pain actually picking up the Aegis. Since Dragonite is not really dying anyway, he hasn't died yet so far, being the only one on his team that hasn't died yet. Klings hasn't died yet either though, so in mid lane both heroes have been having a great time not dying, just getting the farm. It's like a gentleman's agreement, like you don't kill me, I don't kill you. Let's just farm a little bit. Well, although they did deny, so I guess that's not the question. Well, it's obviously not the question, but still. 2100 gold up on the Dragonite. Let's see what it's gonna go for next. Well, he did finish a Shadow Blade. There is an invisibility rune there. Don't think they see it? No, Nidhi didn't see it. The only one that does see it is SGC. But they are afraid to go there right now, especially with all these heroes in the middle. And they should be. This tier 2 tower is looking pretty squishy right now. There is no dragon for another 3 seconds, so we'll be up for the tower if they want to push it, which they probably do. There we go. And they use his dragon form to push in. And Shadow Demon there to make sure that if something happens, he's ready to assist, ready to help out. Clearing the creep wave with the Flame Breath. When's the next creep wave coming in? Not yet. It's still on the other side of the river, so it might take some time. Wonder if they're gonna wait to go for it. In the meantime, on the top lane, Queen of Pain taking a fall does have the Aegis, though. Good job for her. As well, these Aegis got popped, and they want to go for this here to tower instead, because here's actually here to defend it, and the creep wave is here too. So this tower is dead. Radiant's top tower. Fortification is being popped. Miguel is clearing the creep wave that's coming in. Chance creeps will, well, it actually it was Enchantress creeps being turned over to the Chen. So nice job for him. Having a centaur. And they're gonna continue pushing this. See Miguel trying to get a vacuum where he vacuums someone to the lower ground, but didn't work, so they back off. Mike gonna go for this last tier 2 tower here. Now he's almost down, only 500 HP left. He's gonna pick up the creep wave in the middle maybe and then push in, but they might also just farm instead, which is not a bad choice either. 1700 gold up on the Darkseer. Still expect he's gonna go for a pipe, but we'll have to see if that's really the case. Chen has a mech up to heal more in teamfights, or, you know, to have a mech, because it's good in general. With the mech being built up and Enchantress actually not completed yet, still quite a way off. 700 gold left for her to get with Le Shrek. He did get such good farm at the start, got 2 kills, but his items are not that carry-like. I mean, he has a Drummers of Endurance, he has a Ring of Bacillus, but he's not going to be able to take any more kills, or at least you know, walk around with his Pulse Nova not worrying about his mana, because he will be worrying about his mana. Even though he has mana boots too, but no point booster on him.
Double damage
up on Playmate. Let's see if he's gonna use it to kill something, or some heroes rather than some creeps, even though it looks to be just creeps right now. Because he's not gonna find anybody here. In the meantime, SGC is trying to push down this middle lane. As Well, they don't really want to overextend because they don't, at the moment, they don't know where the rest of DD is. We're actually going to see Edict being popped by Tulikt, and he's going to push down this tower. He's very safe to do so. There is a fortification up if they want to use it, which it seems like they don't want to use. Yeah, there is a fortification after the Edict, though. I mean, Tulikt could just walk back in and... oh, never mind, not needed. Queen is taking the tower. And we'll wind walk away, and there's no gem up on Playmate, so we'll be fine. There's no dust up either for Angel, so no dust, no gem. There is a ward, but it didn't get placed. It's a sentry ward. And it looks like DD wants to go for this middle tier 1 tier 2 tower, last tier 2 tower on the map for SGC. And there is, well, there is actually no tower down yet on the bottom lane for DD. I mean, the first tower is still on over 1,000 HP, not getting pushed at all. And this tower will get pushed pretty fast. And these two might look into TP back. There is a Yasha up on the Antimage. He might just wait to farm his recipe for the Manta style. Because his team might be in trouble soon if he doesn't get his farm up. And I mean, to be fair, if you have an anti-mage, you just have to make sure that he gets enough farm faster than the carry of the opponent team, and then not die too much in the meantime. And so far, they have only died 8 times, and it's a 21-minute game, so 8 times is not that much so far. So they've been doing pretty good. I'm just worried to see if it's actually going to be enough farm on the anti-mage to be able to get down. I mean, the Dragonite is so tanky. He is so hard to take down, and he has a Shadow Blade. I mean, even though he probably got it for the invisibility, but he hasn't really used that yet. But yeah. Oh well. It's gonna be tricky for the Anti-Mage to get him down. He will at least be able to get down the Shadow Demon and maybe the Darkseer too. Chen will be hard to do because he has a heal, he has a mech. But then again, if he doesn't have mana, he can't do either of those. And Queen of Pain can just link away if she has mana, and she has a Lincoln Sphere also. Now completed. Let's see though. Manta style completed on the Antimage, so let's see if that's gonna make a difference. He doesn't have a Vanguard, so it's still very squishy. There is no disable yet, apart from the stun on Dragonite. On the Dire team. But if it's gonna be enough to bring him down in the stun time, I mean, Disruption will be there too, maybe helping out a little bit. And because apparently Ryze knows that he is probably one of the most perceptible heroes for the Antimage, as in he's gonna be target number one to get down, he picked up a Ghost Scepter to be able to just ghost himself away, making sure that he's not gonna be dying that fast if there's an Antimage. Venomancer taking a lot of damage, will probably go down here. Queen of Pain being dominating here. As DD is pushing into this 3-3 tower, where Antimage is still just happily pushing on the top lane. He does have a TP on him, and he is actually using it, but it might be too late, or will it be? They won't have a Venomancer Nova, and they might want that stun going off. Stun gets stun 2 on both Angel and Miguel, as the mech goes off, brings everybody back to health. Darkseer Wall is being popped, so nobody wants to walk through that. Vacuum is there too. Shadow Poison going down, Chen ultimate there, everybody of DD apart from Miguel is still almost on full health. As the tower gets pushed down still by Angel, stun going off again, once by Lestrike, and there's the pipe up on the dire side, Venomancer ulti going through, but pipe will make that, annihilate that damage a little bit so that it doesn't do that much damage. In the meantime, Lestrike does get picked off by the Chen, but buys back and TP's back to, cancels his TP actually, because it was a bit of a risky TP. But yeah, DD is still able to just fight. Has a cooldown on the... Oh, Miguel gonna be picked off here. Antimage taking the last hit. As the Holy Persuasion from Chen was too late. Nova going through. Tulik doing a lot of damage. Lestrike taking the kill with his Edict. In the meantime, who do we still have up? We have still have Ryze on the run. We still have Queen of Pain on the run. She will be able to blink away. Blinked away safely towards towards the river. And they're not going to be able... Or will they be able to chase Ryze? No, there's going to be a TP. And there's nothing that Klinks can do to stop him from TPing out. So he's not even going to reveal himself or try to stop him by doing some damage to him. Nice defense from SGC. And this is what they have to do. I mean, they have the anti-mage. But look at this tower. One more push in and this tower will drop. And... it's just very risky then, because Well, of course, there will be no tier 3 tower to defend the barracks. And I hear some complaints about the stream being all black. Try to press pause and then play. It might be fixed up on 720p. Also, Gale going off on Darkseid in the meantime. Guest focus down, will go down. Kling's taking the last hit, but Tulix, Mechchars might save him here. Will actually save him, as the tower hit doesn't finish him off. And the tower is taking a lot of damage. Darkseid is gonna give a pause. And that leaves me time to check if I can do something just to reduce lag, maybe? I don't know. There's nothing I can do, I believe. Connection is working okay. Not dropping. Oh, now I'm dropping frames. Whoa. Let's just see if I can fix this. We still have a pulse though, so it's fine. I can do this. We have nobody saying anything. Oh, sorry, I need a few minutes. Okay, that's fine. It will leave me to see if there's something going on here. We have that closed down too. Let's just not hear the TP going off. That's gotta be an annoying sound. Okay. Then I won't. Holy lag. Holy lag. No. No lag. So all is fine. I'm just gonna check out the stats a little bit while there's still a pause. As Minion said, they needed a couple minutes. So. Oh, we're actually going again already. Well, perfect timing then. I've seen not a lot of kills for a 25 minute game. 19 kills so far. Yeah, like I said, that's the thing you want to do if you have anti-mates. Reduce your kills by as much as you can to try to get the farm advantages. Look at Crane is doing so much damage to this tier 2 tower. Is this gonna drop? Oh, one more last hit. There we go. Gets the right click. Gets the tower back off instantly. SGC will be fine. And the mech completed on Enchantress, which is fun. We have a BKB being completed already on the Klings. He still has the recipe in his stash. We'll have it soon. Invisibility rune on Anti-Mage, who did pick up a Vitality Booster, might be going for a Heart here, as it's pretty late to go be going for a Vanguard. Yeah, we saw the Gold Graph in advantage for DD. But still 5k is not that much. It's actually dropping back now with the towers being dropped. And if we press this button, we see the Experience Graph, which is... It's almost dead even, so no worries there. Oh, Tulix, where are you gonna go? Tulix might be in some trouble here as a double damage rune is up on Dragon Knight. He will get a long range stun off on Tulix as he's here all by himself. Will the long range stun hit? He pops his invisibility rune, or Shadow Blade rather. Give him that extra attack speed. No range stun coming in, but does it need to? He's gonna get a stun off soon. Go get more speed, he will just die here so fast. There we go, Dragonite taking the last hit. Nice job from TBA, and very much overextension from Tulix. He shouldn't have been there by himself on the wrong side of the river with so many heroes of DD missing from the map. And I have to say the same could be said from a lot of SGC heroes right now, as they still think they're pretty free them to farm, but it looks like Enchantress might be in some trouble as Queen of Pain is incoming. We'll be able to just walk away for now. Yeah, we'll be fine. But if Queen of Pain waited with for one of her friends, Enchantress would have gone down. Yeah. Anti-Mage still farming, has a blink, is confident in his ability to get away from that. And we have wards being placed by the Venomancer, which is definitely needed. I mean, like I said, tower is very low and it will go down in probably about 2 hits from the Dragon Knight if he's in the Dragon form. And After the idea that it's gonna kill off Roshan, which they probably will be doing, or want to be doing, they might be wanting to push in the mid lane again. We should run another Pain of Pain, does some harassment on the Antimage, is just gonna back off and blink away, continuing his farm in the jungle. And there we have Roshan being killed off, or at least attempted, but killed off. And it's still could go either way, to be fair. I mean, Antimage is getting more and more farmed. I feel like if DD wants to have a good chance at this, at least being in advantage with at the moment, I feel like they are, sort of. But if they want to keep that, they have to make sure the Antimage doesn't get farmed anymore and continue pushing, because Antimage will get more and more farmed, and the more late game it gets, the less effect, well, the less advantage they will have from the Antimage not being farmed. We have Dragonform up on the Dragonite, we'll pop it soon as the next creep wave is here. Probably have a pipe with that too, as the Darkseer has that one. We have a Gem of Shrewsight on the Queen of Pain. There we have the pipe up, there we have the dragon. Two more hits, Fortification being forced out, long range stun on Enchantress will drop here. Darkseer takes the last hit as the tower goes down. And Darkseer gonna fall here to the Klings, and he does a lot of damage. And Truly just walking around with his Edict up, will take a fall here as there's so much damage coming out from Angel right now. And mega kill for Queen of Pain as she takes things down, who does a lot of damage but is pretty squishy. Same thing goes for the Antimage. Will drop here too, with Queen of Pain being unstoppable double kill for him. Queen of Pain doing her Sonic Wave into thin air. Will go down into the Lushrak, who vault back. And Antimage vault back too, so we'll be here shortly too to defend his barracks. But the melee barracks are already down, with the Shadow Blade there to help him out get away. But Shadow Demon will still drop, and the rest of TBA will be able to get away. It's just two though. But on the kills it was quite even, because there were a lot of buybacks used from CGT, SGC, wow, sorry for that. And the barracks went down, so I think definitely worth it for DD. I mean, they got three deaths out of that, but they killed off more, forced out buybacks, took a tower, took a Rax, definitely worth it. As BKB is being built up on the Dragonite. And And the gold graph drops again towards in favor of DT. Not surprising. Who has the Aegis actually? That could use that. Dragonite has the Aegis, but he still didn't die. I mean, like, in at all. He has 2 for 0 at 7 assists, so I feel like that Aegis would have been more used on the Queen of Pain once again, and she did go down. Queen of Pain has her Scythe of Vice completed, being able to turn Antimage into a Piglet to stop him from doing damage, or Klings for that matter, but Klings now has a BKB, so it will be a bit harder to do that. And no BKB up yet on the Antimage, but he's still saving towards his Reaver to get his heart complete. Top lane is going to be next priority for DD, as they're going to push into this lane and maybe try to take this tower and Rex. Well, probably they will be in time, as that is the goal of the game, sort of. And a mini on his way there will probably take some creeps with him, even though there's no creeps here. Oh yeah, he already has creeps. They're already there ahead of him. And there comes the push in. And not everybody is there yet. There we go. TP's gonna come out from SGC towards the top lane. See if they can defend it. And if they can get some kills and some momentum back. I mean, some extra kills on the Antimage, as he does need that gold and that farm, because it's not completed yet. There goes the pipe. There goes the dragon form. Right click down to the tower being done. So much vacuum is there. Queen of Pain, Sonic Wave hits into the air once again. Shadow Poison forcing people to spread out a bit more. Darkseer was there, Venomancer ultimate going down, but not that much damage being done, even though the pipe was already off. As Venomancer is going to take a fall major to Dragonite, and Enchantress back out of the Shrek will die here, so he doesn't have a buyback this time. Double kill for the Dragonite, as they're going to spot out Klings, because they have a gem. We'll get the Monarch's Purge on him. And triple kill for the Dragonite, as the melee barracks will go down. And the range barracks with that, and probably these two afterwards, and maybe even more. We'll see. Some extra gold for Angel with the little buildings.
Middle barracks are under attack.
Making sure the creeps will focus on the towers next time. Look at that. He can just tank the towers. He's almost regenerating faster than the tower is doing. He has also Terrasse completed. He has a BKB. No Dragon Form anymore though, but he is very tanky, as we can see. He'll take the tier 4 tower. In the meantime, SGC is back up. He's gonna try to take something as Antimage is gonna get disrupted and it's being attacked by some Lucians. Enchantress will drop very fast to the chance. Test of Faith, and Antimage is backing off. It's no man left anymore from his own Lucians draining him. Chen going off on Miguel, does take damage from the Edict, but won't be enough to get him down. As Shrek is on the way, on the way out towards safety from this fountain. Tier 4 tower drops, no GG called yet, but I do believe this is gonna be GG as the tower is ancient is being attacked. Darkseer will still go down to the Shrek, and actually Angel might drop there too for the first time. Angel drops, but there is an Aegis, so it's not dead yet, doesn't count as a death. Turns into a dragon, turns around, focuses on Tulix, will get him down. Unstoppable Angel, kills off the Kling, double kill for him, triple kill if he kills off this Venomancer too. And he will kill off the Venomancer too. Enchantress taking some hits here too, will probably go down. So GG is now being called as Enchantress. Oh no, Rampage for Angel. It's a shame. Or it would of course first be monster kill, but then still. Fortification still going off. Sky Breeze Frost Epicenters. Yeah, it was very painful for the Radiant to deal with that. He is also level 21, and that's a huge level advantage, as the highest level on the on the Radiant is Kling's on level 18. So not being able to get Antimage farm up quick enough. That's the result of this match, with zero death for Angel on the Dragon Knight, which is of course a perfect play for him. As he didn't really win the middle lane, but versus the Kling's, I mean, Dragon Knight versus the Kling's will win late game, so at least he didn't lose it, which is all you can ask for, really. So thank you for watching. This was SGC versus DD, where DD took the win in the Star Series Star Ladder match, and I will probably be casting more, so stay tuned for that, more Star Ladder, or maybe even Pro Dota 2. And then the non-pro version. But we'll see what I'm going to cast next. In the meantime, thank you for watching. You can follow me on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook, all under the name of Shiver Gaming, and of course on Twitch, where you're watching right now. So stay tuned, as I'm going to switch.